think his car has probably got a bit rich. Hands in trouble there for Ron Wright. Ron Wright climbing up on the snowbank, bouncing off into the path of Warwick Barnes, but miraculously they all managed to keep going. And up front it's Bob Smith leading from Ray Houghton. Ray Houghton, Tom Taylor and Antonio Forza in there close behind. Then comes Tony Ashford, but as they come down to the end of the half lap, it's 177 Bob Smith from 142 Ray Houghton, Tom Taylor 29, then 78 Antonio Anthony Ashford with 3-3-3, Terry Briggs making good ground there, 13 Antonio Forza, 77 Warwick Barnes and 67 Ron Wright, who's suffering from that mishap down in Chessens and I think doomed to retirement. But that was the order as they went over the finish line at the end of the half lap with three laps to go. But it's Bob Smith really beginning to pull away now, and Bob told me this morning still not at all happy with the handling of this car, and in these type of conditions it's very, very difficult to sort the handling out because you're not really sure whether it's the conditions or whether it's the car that's causing all of the problems. But I think he's got that handling in the field very well now. Terry Briggs challenging for second place, and Terry Briggs going through into second place with that very, very determined driving style of his with the Renault Alpine. So Terry Briggs into second place, and it looks as though Terry could be setting his sights on something higher than this here this afternoon. Warwick Barnes getting tangled in there with Ray Houghton. Ray Houghton dropping down a couple of places. Warwick Barnes also losing a place down to Tony Ashford, who comes back into fourth place. But it's 177 from 333, 129 Tom Taylor, 77 and 78, literally side by side. 140 at the moment as Warwick Barnes comes up alongside and Tony Ashford once again to go back into fourth place. But we're watching Terry Briggs, we're watching Terry Briggs to see if he can close on Bob Smith as they come down Harry Hill for the completion of two laps, two full laps. 1.5 laps to go, and Terry Briggs getting a little bit closer now to Bob Smith. Bob having to pedal very much, a little bit better in these conditions. He's into third ahead of Tom Taylor. Then comes Tony Ashford, Ray Houghton, Antonio Forza. That's the order. The yellow flag wave. Who have gone? It must be Terry Briggs. Terry Briggs is hidden there somewhere out of my view. Yes, there he is. I can just see him sorting himself out. So Terry Briggs has lost all opportunities now of going into any more finals, and that has made life very much more comfortable for Bob Smith, moved into Rallycross with his twin cam Ford Escort, had some very good drives last year, made his first appearance in Europe last year when he went over to Holland in August, has impressed a lot of people over the winter with his spirit of driving of the twin cam Mark II Ford Escort, and then in late December took delivery of this X-Steen Bradley rear-wheel drive programs from Brands Hatch, and he certainly is beginning to look a very, very Bob then leading Warwick Barnes, the World One team. He's there in second place as they come through at the end of the lap. It looks as though these must then be 4.5 lap races, not 3.5 as in your program. No sign of the checkered flag, so we assume that the race length has been extended by 1 lap to 4.5. Nevertheless, the order remains the same, and for Terry Briggs, I don't think it will make much difference, because he's out once again on the apex of Chesso. Cars are beginning to fall by the wayside, and that's the Chessens for what we think. Yes, it is the last time. The checkered flag is now out, so the race length was extended to 4.5 laps. Behind him, Warwick Barnes will be not too unhappy, I feel, with his second place. I think Anthony Ash will be feeling quite happy with his result with the Fiesta, but it's 177 Bob Smith who moves up into the next final.
Squeezed through into the lead from John Waghorn, Ivan Moakes, Mark Renderson coming in there. Bob Smith with Mark Renderson's out on the outside in fourth place now. Drops down into fourth behind Ivan Moakes, but it's the Sintra and Visa of John Waghorn leading all those powerful cars. 122, 165, 119, 66, 177, 730 and 278. Mark Lloyd, then comes 130, Colin Page, who spun out right down to the tail end of the field. So a really change of fortunes here, and Mark Renderson's absolutely desperately got to do something here, because remember, there's a challenge for Formula C, and it looks very much as though Paul Bullivant is settled nicely for Formula C Championship honours here, unless Mark Renderson can win this. Mark Renderson's desperately got to win this race for both overall and Formula C category honours. At the moment, however, he is in second place, only behind the Visa, and they're all in trouble here. It has to be Barry Wilmot, surely. As Mark Renderson now comes in to challenge for the lead, Barry Wilmot has defectively. Meanwhile, John Waghorn has now extended his lead over number 66, Mark Renderson. Well, in third place, it is still 177, Bob Smith from Mark Lloyd, 278, who's moved up now ahead of 7:30, Dave Ward, with Ivan Mokes staging a recovery, but up front is Mark Renderson looking for the lead, and the Citroën Visa, I think, in trouble. A Citroën Visa, now Mark Renderson's in the lead. Mark Renderson had to do this. He had to get into the A final, not just for the overall situation, but also for the Formula C race. So Mark Renderson's doing everything he possibly can at the moment. We've got Visa pulling off. We've got 119 Ivan Mokes, 130 Colin Page, who's getting in there with them following that mishap on the first corner. But look at Mark Lloyd. Mark, who made that terrible start and was right down at the tail end of the field. He's up now into third place, but still finding the going very, very treacherous indeed for the rear-wheel drive front engine cars, although Mark Renderson finding things quite to his liking at the moment. So Mark Renderson, tipped by many, of course, as a future British champion, and a man whom we think will be very, very shortly fielding a four-wheel drive car for the Darlington Simpson Rolling Mills team. Mark Renderson then, the young farmer from Cleasby, the early leader of this championship, who's had a very bad mid-season run down here with misfire problems on the car. Could only make the B final today, you see, but doing everything he has to do in this B final, leading it still at the moment, although Bob Smith hasn't given up the hunt yet. They're well in second place. The conditions out there seem to be really treacherous now. It really is very, very slippery. Still, Dave Ward from Great Dunmo holding off Ivan Mokes, who's clawed his way back to fourth place. Back. Oh, that's heart-rending for Mark Lloyd. So Mark Lloyd in a lot of problems here now, and it looks as though he's not going to take the Formula B title. It looks as though Will Gollop will probably get that as well. It really is going to be a super final that we have here at the very end of the afternoon to round off this championship. I do believe that Mark Renderson looks as though he's going to be in there amongst the top eight cars, as Mark Lloyd is back onto the circuit. Mark Lloyd has been allowed to rejoin, but he cannot find any traction, and he is lapped there by Mark Renderson, who goes gently past, allowing Lloyd to find the 4.5 lapper. Bob Smith immediately, who's gone off again, so Mark Lloyd in a lot of troubles. There must be something wrong with the car. Mark has gone off again very comprehensively on the outside of Chesson's Drift as Mark Renderson comes through to take his car into the A final for the very last race of the 1985-86 Lydon Winter Rallycross Championship. The reigning champion on the front row of the grid, number 8, Dimi Mavropoulos. The man who is sitting on a Lydon hat-trick and former champion. Beside him, number 1, Trevor Hopkins. On the second row, the man who is favourite to win the championship for the very first time here this afternoon, Will Gollop. Beside Will, one of two drivers who can take the Formula C Championship here this afternoon, that's Paul Bullivant. On the third row, another former three times Lydon champion, Trevor Reeves, who's here really to sort the Group A RS Turbo out, and surely by getting into the A final in this company proves that that car is very, very competitive, and I'm sure along with everyone else, you'll join me in wishing Trevor the very best for the 1986 European Championship. Then we have Vic Morris, a man who has tied on points with Barry Crump for the Formula D Championship, but we think Barry gets it by virtue of the most wins. On the back row, the current leaders of the Formula A and Formula C Championships here at Lydon. Can they take those titles at the end of this race? John Smith and Mark Renderson are right there. Well clear there of Whitstable Will Gollop, but this time it's Trevor Hopkins. Hawkins going round the outside, and again, Demi Mavropoulos can do nothing but sit there and watch it happen. And it's Demi Mavropoulos from the outside, and already John Smith is in trouble. John Smith is in trouble, and it's number one, Trevor Hopkins, and number eight, Demi Mavropoulos. 18, Worcester will well guard. 118, Paul Bullivant. Then comes number three, Trevor Reeves. 66, Mark Renderson. 366, Quick Beck Mice. 44, John Smith completes the order. That's the way they go round the first time, round the Devil's Elbow and up Perry Hill. And at the moment, no positional changes looking imminent. The man who's got a lot of work to do here at the moment is John Smith, because if John Smith's going to retain the lead in the Formula A Championship, he's got to be a lot higher place than he is at the moment, and I don't somehow think he's going to do it, and it looks as though Formula A might well fall to one of these two drivers. But look at Demi. Demi as they go through the chicane and down to the chest for the second time. Winston will win. Then comes number 118, Paul Warren. Then Trevor Reeves, number 3. Then 66, Mark Renderson. I think Mark Renderson might be in line for the Formula C title, provided he can hold station where he is and doesn't let Paul Bullivant get any further away from him. Mark Renderson trying to get the rear-wheel drive escort past the front-wheel drive through A version overall. The top Formula B car is Will Gollop flying third overall, and Will Gollop's quite happy there to stay. Up front, Demi Mavropoulos knows he can't take the championship. He knows he's lost his title, but it would be lovely to beat Trevor Hopkins down here on Hoppy's home territory. But Trevor Hopkins is looking for his fourth consecutive rallycross victory here in Great Britain, and having achieved a British hat-trick, he's now looking for a Lydon hat-trick to follow on from those two victories here and the one 2 weeks ago at North Weald. Here Ashville got up safely there, still in first place from Paul Bullivant. And in comes Trevor Reeves. But in Formula A, that's where the big changes look like coming, because John Smith, he may well reverse that situation, and it looks very much by virtue of three consecutive victories here at Lydon Hill as though Trevor Hopkins may take the Lydon Hill Formula A Championship. A championship which at one stage looked almost certain to go the way of John Smith when he was dominating the early runs of this championship with the four-wheel drive Porsche. But of course, no four-wheel drive here today hasn't helped John one little bit. But meantime, Trevor Hopkins really playing with the opposition, I feel here, driving the Ford Escort. And Will Gollop in trouble. Oh dear, Will Gollop in trouble, dropping down a couple of places there. And that's going to change the situation somewhat. It's going to have a little bit of mathematics here now. Mark Renderson and Paul Bullivant going past. Well, that was most unexpected that Will Gollop should do that kind of thing, as Trevor Hopkins completely back again. Will it affect his championship chances or will it not? This is very, very exciting now. Will Gollop, a quick count up of the points overall. Will Gollop, of course, definitely the Formula B champion. It looks as though Mark Renderson's going to take the Formula C and Trevor Reeves the Formula A, but it's all rather uncertain at the moment for the overall, which of course is the big one. We'll count the points up, but we can't do that until they've taken the checkered flag. Remember, the Wenham car's, of course, still dominating the situation with just over a lap to go. And Will Gollop doesn't look as though he's going to make up any more place entry there in fourth place. Getting close, just a place behind Paul Bullivant overall here today. Can Mark Renderson get past Paul Bullivant on this last lap? I don't think Will is getting a little bit nerve-wracking here at the moment. Mark Renderson's going to pick up very good points here, but John Smith isn't. It's all down to Mark Renderson, really. Mark Renderson really does want to get that second place, or that third place. That would do Mark Renderson a lot of good, would give him 100 and enable Will to lose the championship. The checkered flag is being raised. The cars are on their last lap. Trevor Hopkins is going to come through. He will... That gives him 205 points. Demi Mavropoulos is second.